Good morning, it's me, Edwina Oliver again. I actually was just here and I just wanted to come back because I was sitting here watching my twins tear up the place. It's 7:20 and we were already set destruction in motion here. But I was sitting here and I was just thinking about a couple people that I know, some really hardworking women, and I was thinking, gosh, I gotta get these ladies together because I gotta share with them what I know. Like, I have to share with them. It's not, it doesn't have to go down the way we've been trained to go down. You know, it's weird. I'm gonna say this, Kanye West, when he was going off on his little rants on TMZ and a couple other places where he was just being really vocal about the fact that, and he was wearing the MAGA hat, and, you know, he was just vocal about how the people, African-American people mainly, and other people, because other people are the same way, keep themselves oppressed, right? Other people keep themselves oppressed, and slavery is in your mind, you know, and you're still slaves today because it's in your mind. I thought to myself, Saturday Night Live, that's what it was. I thought to myself, Kanye then left the building. I thought he left the building when he got up behind Taylor Swift and yep. But now I know the building, it's gone right now, right? It's amazing. And then time passes, a little bit of time passes, and a little bit of life starts to shift a little bit more. And I learned more and more and more and more about financial literacy and all of the things that are available so that you do not have to be a slave to your job, to your career, to your children, to your fucking life. Keeping it real right now. That doesn't have to, the hustle doesn't have to go straight into your 60s. For real. You know what I'm saying? Worrying about what's happening Saturday night or worrying about what's happening next weekend should be the least of anybody's worries. You're in your late 30s, as I am. Aren't you curious how the next 20 are gonna go? Because I know these last 39 years swings flew by. I mean, I'm like, oh my gosh, don't want the year to end because I'll be 40 at the beginning of next year. I'm like, God. Right? I'm like, how is the next 20 years going to be looking? How do I want them to look? Because I can decide. Right? If I'm a slave up here, I'm not going to be doing what I need to be doing down here. And that goes for everybody. If you're just work, and that's all you're focusing on, and that's all you got planned, you need to sit back down and plan out a 6-year plan of how you're going to stack some serious cash, how you're going to make it grow. So making it grow, you're going to invest in something. Invest in yourself first, get wise, get smart, and then start investing in other things. Get yourself a piece of real estate, okay? Whether it's a rental property, whether you're flipping it, or whether you're going to live in it. You need to own something. Don't just be out here renting away. So that's really all I really wanted to say. I felt the download kind of come in and I just wanted to spit it back out. Because I don't want to hoard this information. I think this is really important information. And, you know, I've got some older friends, you know, I wish that they would have spit some real savvy financial savviness to me. Instead of just letting me go through my, you know, life. And it's no one's responsibility. All right? It isn't. But if you have the knowledge, why not share it? Right? Okay. So that's all I want to say. It's Monday. I know everybody's waking up. And you got to go to work. Right? And you're supposed to have this kick-ass attitude about it. It's Monday for me. And this is my work. Me hitting a button and going on YouTube and telling you guys what I know is my job. Because I got tired of doing the other thing. Right? I want to see my kids. Mm-hmm. I want to play with Elmo. Feel me? It's Monday, but it doesn't have to be an unfun day. You know what I'm saying? Sunday fun day should be Monday, even funner day. You know what I'm saying? So, how is the next 10 years going to look for you? You going to keep grinding for somebody else? You start grinding for yourself. And that's up here, too, in every aspect. You know, we have to wake up. The system isn't working for everybody. And that goes to show just on home prices. I'm looking at houses now, and I am like, first of all, if you don't upkeep your house, why do you think that you get to hit market? You get full market value for your home. That is what I see out there right now, people trying to get. We're looking at Petaluma, and I'm appalled at what I've seen so far. I'm like, is this a joke? People are asking for $700,000 for a home that was built in 1951, and they have not done a single new window. You just lived in the place till the wheels fell off, and now the wheels are falling off, and you want to sell it to somebody else so that they can pay you full market price, and I'm like, I'm glad I'm not naive to the game. Like, I see what's going on in the market, and I'm going to wait y'all out on the prices, or I'll just go back to Marin and really spend something where my value is going to hold, right? See, I wouldn't have been thinking like that 10 years ago. It was just get where I wanted to be and blah, blah, blah. But I've already gone through a foreclosure. I've already gone through that heartbreak, you know? And nobody wants to do that again. You know, you get something that's over the top. Next thing you know, you're under the water. Right? So prepare and get something. You got to fix everything. Home repairs aren't cheap. Water heaters, furnaces. You okay, baby? I know, I saw. You're all right. You fall down so you can get back up, right? That's right. You fall down and get back up. Come on. Ugh. And I want her to have something, you know? And I want to be able to just enjoy time with my babies, all four, and not miss time, precious time, that I'd be missing with her and her brothers if I had to drop them off at daycare. And someone else gets to tell me when they're taking their first steps, and someone else is gonna tell me they did this today. I feel like I missed out. I'm like, oh. And all your money goes to it because daycare is not cheap. Oh my God. But it is a job, and it's, you know, a lot of mothers will understand the job that they don't get paid for is an intense job. There's a lot going on throughout the course of that day, right? So anyway, I hope that somebody got my message. I'm a scattered talker, and I hope that I can be of service to all of you out there. And let's make the world what we want it to be. It's ours to do that. We can harness it and do that. So let's do it together. All right, take care.